Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Glad you guys can make it. Today I just want to talk to you about this one thing that every fish keeper should do or should be prepared to do, and that is to smash that like button. All jokes aside, simply put, the one thing that every fish keeper needs to keep in mind that their future in fish keeping is going to involve this thing, or their lives are going to revolve around this one thing, is water changes. Okay, someone's excited. Now, you might be thinking, Chris, dude, everyone and their grandmas know about this. Yes, but again, with these types of topics, it's not about knowing or not that this thing exists. It's about knowing just how important and crucial and critical this thing is to the whole hobby. Now, yes, I am one of the biggest fans of the Wallstead method of understocking a tank and putting a lot of plants in the tank so that you don't have to do so many water changes, and sometimes you don't have to do any water changes. So why is someone like me all of a sudden making a video about raving about the magic of water change? Basically, they are pretty magical. Now, there are fish tanks that you don't need to do water changes on, and people have struck that amazing balance. There are even entire fish rooms and fish stores that don't require any water changes on any of their fish tanks, and that's wonderful. I myself strive for less water changes, as little as possible. Case in point, for this tank, I haven't done one in years. So what's the big deal, Chris? You trying to get us to do some work that is not needed to be done, that you don't even do yourself? No. Think of water changes as you would think of technology. For example, for university or high school, when something goes wrong for like a presentation or something and your professor or teacher has to call in the geek squad, they have to call in the tech support. What do the tech support do the first thing they come into the room? They don't even really check out the situation. They just go and they're like, is this not working? Yeah? Okay. Unplug. Wait a few seconds. Plug back. And magically, that actually works. And sometimes when our own computers at home are acting up and we've tried everything that Google has told us to, sometimes we just sleep it off and the next morning, it actually works again when you turn it back on. This is somewhat of an equivalent situation to water changes. Are your fish showing some symptoms of illness? Do they have ick? Do they have fin rot? Are your water parameters really bad right now? When in doubt, water change. In my experience, water changes have saved many of my fish's lives. Throughout my decade of keeping fish, decade plus now, I'm really dating myself here. A simple action of doing one single water change has meant life instead of death for a lot of my fish. Or at least it's meant better water conditions or less fin rot, less ick, overall less ammonia poisoning and burns. And if you're someone who doesn't have a tank that doesn't need that many water changes, if you're someone who is hoping to get into this hobby, you're doing everything right, you got the 10-gallon setup for a good understocked or just like a normal stocking, nothing abusive, no Noah's Ark syndrome and all that crap, but you're coming in without the mindset of having to do regular weekly at least water changes of 25 to 30%, I'm sorry to say, but that is not possible. You need to do those regular water changes. Oftentimes your water might actually still look clear even though you do need a water change. You don't know this, especially if you don't have a way to test your water. Regular water changes are so important. Now notice how I say this is the one thing that you should do, but only for the situation that I just described. If you are someone who's keeping a bed of fish in like a 2-gallon, if you're someone who has like 20 goldfish in a 10-gallon, of course the first thing and the only thing that you should do in that scenario is do more research, take a pause, and just equip yourself with the right knowledge of how to keep fish. But this message is for the average person who's got everything right going for them but haven't gotten to the mindset of doing a regular water change schedule. I'm willing to bet 99% of your problems, 99% of the things and issues that rise from the health of your fish are due to the fact that you might not be doing regular water changes. So like I said, the average minimum should be at least one weekly water change for 25 to 30% of the water, but obviously that changes depending on the stocking of your fish tank, the size of your fish tank. Having a water change schedule doesn't automatically mean once per week. Depending on your setup and your experience with your water parameters, it could be anywhere from like 3 times a week for 50% water changes to like once per 2 weeks. This is just something that you have to work out with yourself, that you have to discover on your own time with your own experience. Of course, if you have like 15 fish in a 10 gallon and you feed them a lot every day, you should expect more frequent water changes at a larger amount. So this is pretty much the video. I just wanted to get this PSA out there, this message out there, that if you're gonna own a fish tank, expect to do some form of water changes on some kind of schedule. Make sure to share this with someone who's struggling to understand that water changes are crucial and critical for their pet fish to survive. Share this with any new fish tank owners that you might know. Just make sure they're aware of what they're getting themselves into. And of course, it also works as a sort of hack that, you know, when you're in doubt, you can always pull that plug and replug it back, which is basically what a water change does in an emergency situation. I have literally had fish that broke out in ick that I just did a water change, and the next morning they already started to heal, and then by the week ended, they were already fine. And I just did this to hold off the Melafix dosing and other medication. Instead of having to dose medication, how much better or easier would it be just to do a water change? And even better, regular water changes. Don't slack like I did. All right, if you guys enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe. There'll be more videos to come, and don't forget to get your hands wet. Tetra, 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 we in a spot, coming in hot, ventral fin die, acclimate that. With my shoal act, cure my fin rot, from Carasiformes to Parachirodon, hold on. There's not another fish that you can wish for, live fam says I finna one. I finna gone 3 days without furt, I'm an addict, like fanatic, I'm a baddest, no tabs, only dirt. My Cory gang so loyal, black tetra go skirt, we came to play, came to silence, gang.